What's up, guys? John Garofano, Strength is Life. Just wanted to talk a little bit more about a topic that Greg and I were just
starting to talk about.
We were talking about it. We're like, oh, let's turn the camera on. So we were talking about one of our biggest pet peeves when people come to us for help and guidance, and that's asking a question but not listening.
Not liking the answer.
Not liking the answer and not listening. One of the big questions I get often is, hey, John, you know, what kind of protein should I have, or what supplement should I take so I can get big or I can get ripped? And I say, simply, you know, the supplements and the protein are only a way to help you to get to your goal. What's more important is your training and your nutrition and looking at the big picture. And, you know, the response I typically get is, oh, well, you know, I don't want to eat right or anything, but I want to get big, or I want to get, you know, I want to bench more, or I want to do this. And it's very frustrating, because what you're saying, that would be like going to your doctor and being like, listen, I want to get healthy, but I'm not willing to do anything about it. And it's like, what is your doctor going to do? Hold on, let me write you a script for this medicine that's going to cause 3 or 4 other side effects that are going to become issues for you.
Yeah.
And so you can take 2 other medications for those side effects.
To reverse the side effects of the first medicine.
Right, exactly. And it's just asinine. You know, you have to be willing to do the work and put the time in and listen to the people that are guiding you. It's very frustrating when, like, I've had clients who say to me, oh, well, I'm not getting results, or I'm not doing this. Or if I get a text message from someone, oh, I'm sore after squatting. We're all sore after squatting.
I'm sore every goddamn day.
Yeah, I walk around constantly sore.
I walk around like an 80-year-old to get in better shape.
Yeah, we were working out this weekend with, you know, a bunch of people from the show. Like, for example, Paul Revelia, and I'll bring up a story. He's been having some issues with his hip and his hip flexor. And, you know, he's talking about how he basically is walking around in pain all the time, but he still gets his ass to the gym and does the work and puts the time in. He just knows that he has to do certain things to make himself feel better. Like, he has to foam roll and stretch and do all this stuff. And it kind of goes along with that. Like, you know that you have to put in the work. If you want to get big, you need to be in a caloric surplus. If you want to grow muscle, you have to be in a caloric surplus. Not too much, you're going to gain fat. You have to be looking at your overall food intake, hitting your macronutrient numbers. You have to focus on energy balance. These are all things that you probably know, but are hard. And this goes to another topic we were talking about. Human beings are inherently lazy. I can't tell you how many times.
Yes, you are. Don't even argue.
It's true. How many times I've had an athlete go, no, I don't want to do that because that's hard work. Do you want to share the email that you had with me, the exchange about the carbs? Talk about that.
All right. Yeah, yeah. So, for instance,
that's an example.
I'll try to tilt this so we can kind of both be in it.
Yeah.
My biggest problem is I'm 212 pounds, and believe it or not, even in a bulk right now, I think I'm hitting 2,800 calories. Yeah, I know there's girls out there who eat more than me in their off season.
On our team,
mind you, that eat more than me. And I don't know what it is, but when I was younger, man, I could house half a cow. It was no big deal. I can eat food never ending. But after my shows, and I guess I'm just getting older, and also due to the fact that my physical activity really only consists of the gym, because I am at a desk job all day where I used to be playing basketball all day. So, but we were having a discussion about getting my carbs up. So John and I have tried multiple times to get my carbs up, and what ends up happening is once I hit about 300 grams of carbs, I start to feel like an elephant. I feel bloated, I feel full, I feel disgusting, I literally feel like a pregnant woman, I feel horrible, I bloat, I hold a lot of water, I just want to be rolled everywhere in a wheelbarrow because I don't want to move, and nothing would make me happier than just to go to sleep. So, you know, John and I had discussed a couple things about when I'm going to compete again. So I'm definitely competing again in 2014, but we were discussing whether I was going to compete early 2014 or fall of 2014. And the reason why this is important is because John and I had a very important discussion as to what would make the most sense. So since I've been struggling with getting my calories up and kind of boosting my metabolism, we decided we're going to do fall of 2014. I need more time to get my metabolism up. It's not comfortable for me to eat those amount of carbs. It's not easy for me to eat those amount of carbs. It's not convenient for me to carry that amount of carbs on me to and from work so that I can get them in. But it's something that I know needs to be done, because what's going to happen is when I go to cut, if I'm only eating 2,800 calories, what the hell am I going to cut from?
Yeah.
Down to 2,000, then what happens if I hit a sticking point? Then I'm going to start going under 2,000. And then I'm going to start running into the same issues issues that Lane Norton has been doing a wonderful job talking about, which is those metabolic adaptations, or the metabolic damage, however you want to phrase it, where I'm going to get stuck, and no matter what I do, I'm not going to be able to shed fat anymore, and we're actually going to be doing more harm to my body, especially when I try to come back out in terms of restoring my metabolism. So,
or the other piece is you end up having to, along the way during your prep, actually having to stop, take a diet break,
yeah,
and then come back, which is a good tool, but you would have to use that too frequently and you'd end up dieting twice as long.
Exactly. So these are all some of the issues that we run into. And, you know, John was talking to me about why I have personally so far have not chosen to, like, really coach anybody. My background at one point is I was a personal trainer for a little while. And what I noticed with a lot of people is they talk about wanting to be the best or talk about reaching their goals, but that's just a lot of BS. It's more of them trying to toot their own horn and convince themselves that that's the case, but it's really not.
Or they want a trainer so they can socialize.
Oh, yeah, or they want more of the fact to go around telling their friends that they hired a personal trainer, not so much that they're really attempting to change any part of their lifestyle to get the results that they want. You know, and I'm the kind of guy that John's a little bit nicer. He's a little bit more, well, a lot nicer, not a little nicer.
Just
a little bit. But I'm more the kind of guy that if I was going to train somebody, it's kind of my way or the highway. I'm not going to be easy on you. I'm not going to be nice about it. And if you're going to start complaining, I'm going to tell you to shut up, man up, woman up, whatever it is. Tough it out. Competing is not fun. Getting into the shape that you really want to get into is not easy. It's a true lifestyle choice, which means whether you're traveling or whatever your job requirements are or whatever it is, or, you know, kids, wife, family, house, you still have to adapt that lifestyle into the rest of your life. It's the way it goes.
Can I just jump on this? I just fired two clients who were amazing people. I love them a lot. But there was just some issues of, you know, not following through, not touching base, and it just didn't work out. And, you know, that's the thing. You could be great people, but when it comes down to time and investment, I don't have time to continue to invest in something that's not performing. It's like the stock, right?
Yeah.
If I see the stock continue to go down and the company's not doing anything to go in the other direction, I'm going to stop investing and I'm going to pull my stuff out, I'm going to throw my cards in, and I'm going to go to another stock. I mean,
And the other thing, guys and girls for this matter, all of you want, and this is a result I'm noticing, especially with the younger generation, you want to do 1% of the work and get 100% of the results. It doesn't work that way. You know, when I committed to lifting, let's just start with lifting, forget bodybuilding at this point, just to get in better shape and to get bigger and put muscle on. I know you guys don't believe it, you see me on the video, and I really don't want to put up a picture of me of what I used to look like, because I hate them, but I was 165 pounds, soaking wet with rocks in my pockets. You know, I was a beanpole. I really was. I played a lot of sports, and I had no weight on me.
By the way, we're passing Gainesville. Yeah. I just thought it would be.
We're in Florida?
No, right there. You want to get to Gainesville, you got to do...
Yes, you got to go to Gainesville. Yes, Gainesville. We might start using it as a catchphrase, Gainesville.
Yeah.
It's a Gaines.
Well, no.
Gainesville.
There's somebody who already does that, actually.
Oh, really? Well, yeah. We'll steal it anyway. I don't give a crap. But, you know, I came into the gym with the expectation that it's going to take time. Why? Because I'm not taking any super supplements. And by the way, even if you are taking the super supplements, you're not going to just inject yourself and become a muscle man in 2 freaking weeks. It still takes time and work and diet and dedication. So get that crap out of your head, okay? I've seen plenty of guys who've taken juice and they're fat and they've never gone anywhere with it because they've never lived the lifestyle. So the juice and the super supplements don't work miracles either, okay? So that's not even a true shortcut. It might get you there a little faster, but you still got to put in the work.
And this goes back to what Greg was talking about and our email exchange, that, you know, Greg was basically fighting me on me pushing his food intake up, particularly carbs. And you know,
I love protein and fat.
Yeah, Greg's like, you know, I can't do that. Not doing that. And my comeback was, you're lazy. Stop it. Do it and eat. And
I still told him no.
But you're doing better. You've been coming closer.
I'm starting to, you know, every week or two, I try to maybe bump up my carbs by about 10 to 20 grams. And hold that throughout the week. I don't want to do it too fast because I think it'll be too much for my body to handle, and then I'll start packing on the body fat, so I don't want to do that. I mean, I've been staying pretty lean.
The other thing that people have to understand about you is that you are a very large person, and I'm not making fun of you. You are a very large person, and for your size and your metabolism, you can actually take big increases in a short period of time. You actually do better with like a 10 to 15 gram carb increase in a week and hold that for like 2 to 3 weeks than someone doing 5 grams per week.
Yeah.
And mentally, that just messes you up.
Yep.
It mentally messes you up. You have trouble doing that, and you end up not hitting the number.
Yep.
And so whereas I might take 110 pound female and give her a 5 gram carb increase and maybe a 2 gram fat increase, you know, per week to get up to a certain number, you need like a 15 to 20 gram carb increase.
So in other words, I eat like a 110 pound girl.
You said it, not me, brother.
But, you know, you can look at all the magazines you want, and you can look at all the supplements, and you can buy all the top-of-the-line stuff. But in the end, ladies and gents, you have to commit 100%. You know, they do that 70% gym, 30% diet. That's an easy, or whatever it is, 70% diet, 30% gym, or whatever the stupid catchphrase is.
It's still 100%. It still has to equal 100%.
But in all reality, everything has to be in line. It's 100% gym and 100% diet. I mean, it's a little simpler to understand 70-30 or 60-40 or 50-50 because the simplicity and the laziness of our brains to comprehend anything else, but...
This is what I say. It still has to be 100%. Like, I love when people are like, oh, well, you know, 70% is diet, so if I just have a clean diet, I don't need to exercise.
Really? As hard or as much.
Really, because you just got a 70%.
Yeah.
Go to school and tell me how that 70%
is. Yeah, it's barely passing.
Exactly. You're barely passing. What results are you getting? My point is this. Everything. You got to get your sleep in order. Hydration, supplementation, nutrition, training. Everything has to be in order. Stress management.
Oh, and by the way, the supplementation is this much of the whole key.
2-3%, maybe.
You're lucky if it's 5.
Yep.
So I think that with the fitness industry and all the pills and stuff that they try to shove down our throat, these miracle pills, take the green coffee extract. You'll burn fat.
Raspberry not ketone.
Not if you're sitting still, you're not. It doesn't matter what you take. All right? If you're not moving, you're not burning calories.
I can't even tell you how many times at work or just, you know, I'm at the gym. Hey, what fat burner can I take? I just need to lose this other 10 pounds of fat. And my response is the best fat burner in the world. High-intensity interval training coupled with resistance training.
And diet.
You know, and a good, clean diet. And the person goes, yeah, but besides all that.
Yeah.
My point, people are lazy. Human beings are lazy.
You know, listen, guys, you know, we want the best for you. We want you to understand what the reality is. You know, I don't want to give anybody any unrealistic expectations. If you want the results, you have to put in the work. There's no other way around it. Even if you take super supplements, you still have to put in the work. I don't care. The results may come quicker, but you still have to live the lifestyle. Otherwise, it's not going to work for you. I know plenty of guys who have taken juice, and I look 100 times better than they do because I make sure that my diet's in line and my nutrition's in line, and I'm doing my cardio, and I'm getting my sleep, and I'm drinking water, and I'm doing everything else that I'm supposed to be doing.
So you just, you know, to wrap it all up, I think the key thing is what Greg just said. You need to put the work in. You need to focus on all of the areas that matter. You know, focus on the things that matter. You know, maybe don't put as much energy and attention to the things that, you know, don't matter as much, like clean versus, you know, non-clean foods, and a very minimalist, you know, very reductionist mentality. You know, a lot of people have that in the fitness industry. Focus on the things that matter. Do the whole package. Commit to it. Make it a goal. And when it gets rough, push through it. Push your body to adapt. The body will adapt to what you give it.
Good or bad.
Exactly. Your body's going to adapt if you lay on a bed and eat pizza all day. There are plenty of TV shows, we were talking about this earlier, of people who just refuse to move and refuse to do anything. Your body will adapt to that. It's called get fat. If you want to be strong, have muscle, be lean, live long, you have to get out there and move. You have to eat the right foods. You have to sleep. You have to hydrate. All the things that matter. So with that, we'll probably riff a little more on some more topics, but that's a wrap for that one.
Later.